did it.
When Cynthia Weaver was downstairs at breakfast, Rose snuck into her room. With all the lamps in the room, it took her a while to find the one with an angel. Luckily, the dream Alan had sent her had been very clear. Rose was certain that Cynthia would not miss one lamp. She had so many. Tonight, Rose would put the lamp in a shoebox and let it sink into the garden pond. That's what Alan wanted. That's how she could help him. The thought made her whole body buzz with joy. Cynthia knew the lamp was missing the very moment she came back to her room. She was overcome by grief. It had been Tom's lamp, one of the few things that reminded her of him. It had not worked in a long time with the cord severed and the light switch gone. But there are other kinds of lights than the ones we can see. The invisible light of the angel lamp had held Cynthia together all these years. With tears welling in her eyes, she didn't see the shadows shifting in the corners of her room.
Tor's here, in the overlap. Gotta find him and get the fuck out. Overlaps require pieces of art to enter. Is that because of the Dark Place's focus on art? Sure. We need to talk.
Damn right. Lots for me to explain. But not here. The Knight's got ears. We can have our talk in your head. You have a room there, right?
How do you know about that?
I'm your grandfather. What don't I know?
About my mind place? How is that possible?
We all have the power. Find the truth. Damn right I do. Odin already told you you're a seer. You can gaze into their heads, see the truth. See past the lies. Past this bullshit horror story. Us Andersons aren't bound by it. You can fight it. Don't be the story. Make the story.
It's true. I am a seer. I have a power. My mind place is more than I thought it was. This isn't my intuition. I'm seeing their thoughts. Is this why I know the truth about Logan? While everyone else forgot? You said you were my grandfather. If that's true, why wasn't I told about you?
You were part of our fucked up family, way before this horror story. I was a shitty fucking dad to Freya. Your mom didn't deserve that. Not one bit. Things were said and done. Not a day goes by I haven't regretted it. But that fucking father of yours didn't make things any easier. I know Freya is gone. So I need to apologize to you. I am sorry, Saga.
I can see he's sorry. Mom said she didn't want anything to do with my grandfather. And that my father died before I could remember. It all matches. Thor and Odin aren't part of my family. I have the clicker. Can I use it to save my daughter?
An amp? Get your guitar roaring and your drums crashing. Blow reality's eardrums. Just the light switch isn't enough. It's Tom's story we're dealing with. So he's gotta be the one to rewrite it. After that's done, he can flick that switch to bring the whole thing home, baby.
I can't use the clicker without Wake. Tom. Meaning Wake. He needs to rewrite the story first. I can't stop the horror story without him. You said you were a shitty father to my mom. Is that why she left?
Freya never looked back. My girl was strong. Freya always thought our powers had a dangerous side. Odin and me did fuck with things that should not have been fucked with. Your mom had common sense. She raised you right. Kept you safe. I'm not surprised she didn't tell you about the Anderson power.
She was always protecting me. Whenever I told my mom about my mind place, she called it make-believe. I wish she'd been more honest with me. At least towards the end. Mom wouldn't talk about my father. You knew him?
Some doors are better left closed. Your dad was a complicated bastard. Always thinking too many steps ahead. That's not how we work. There was trouble, and then he was gone. I didn't handle it well. Freya didn't want anything to do with me after that. I can't blame her.
I never knew my dad or my mom's family. So many broken relationships in my past. I won't lose mine. With Logan. With David. I won't stop until they're safe. Wake needs to be the one to rewrite the ending. And I'll need to keep an eye on him.
Your dad was a complicated bastard. Always thinking too many steps ahead. That's not how we work. There was trouble, and then he was gone. I didn't handle it well. Freya didn't want anything to do with me after that. I can't blame her.
The way Tor behaved? I'm surprised my mom hung around for as long as she did. But he is genuinely sorry. Wake wrote Logan into the story. He had no right to use her like this. There is still time to make him fix it. I won't give him a choice. Thanks for telling me this, Tor. I need to go find Wake to stop this.
The old gods of Asgard will be ready to help. Me and my bro will bring the rock when you need it. Remember, your daughter is alive. Just kept from you by this bullshit horror story.
I needed to hear that. Thanks, Grandpa.
Don't worry about me, kiddo. I'll drag my sorry ass over to Odin. A few shots of the Anderson's finest will fix us both up. See you soon, Saga.
The FBC is holding wake at the sheriff's station. I need to make Agent Estevez understand. They have Wake, and I have the clicker. We have to work together to stop this. Casey. Do you read me, Casey? Damn it. Where... He better be okay. Focus, Saga. Get to the station. To Wake. Get the clicker to Wake, and make him fix his attempt to play God. That's the plan. But the FBC have him.
Oh, who knows with that girl? I always see her running off in the middle of the night.
Good for her. Live life while you can.
Huh. A lady should be in bed with her Christie novels at that hour.
Oh, boo. Don't be so old-fashioned.
Another cult box.
I sister you! Faces! Hit! Behind! Mask!
Another lunchbox.
Up next, we have a guest lined up. Have it written down in your somewhere.
them from the back.
Percolator! Ultimately.
When the government seized the land around Cauldron Lake and set up their laboratory there, Ilmo Koskela knew they knew something. Together with his brother, they felt obliged to take a look inside. The Federal Bureau of Control Security was a joke. The Koskelas walked in delivering coffee. Back in Watery, they pored over the stack of files they grabbed. The FBC was researching something in the lake, something they called the Shadow. Everyone who went into the lake came back a monster. Hartman had gone into the lake. He'd come back bad. The FBC had captured him, interrogated him. Based on his ravings, Barbara Jagger had gone into the lake as far back as the 60s. She'd come back bad. The writer, Alan Wake, had gone into the lake. He'd face Jagger, pushed some mystic light switch into a hole in her chest, flicked the switch and gotten rid of her. If Wake ever came back, he was bound to be bad as well. Every night was bingo night at the Valhalla nursing home. Each time Rose drew a ball from the cage and called out its number, some of the residents shouted bingo, no matter what was on their cards. Some of them sat mute, their cards full, never calling out. Some of them would try to steal the ball from her. Some of them would chastise the others for acting out. It was like herding a clowder of cats. Rose didn't mind. She liked cats. She knew she was where she was supposed to be, with her little Vikings. Waiting for the hero to come. Tonight, the residents were restless, more so than usual. Ati was wearing Blum's coveralls again. Tor stood by the phone. Too late. Rose saw the hammer in his hand. The garden lights started to flicker, the darkness and rain pressing against the windows. The time drew nigh. The 81st annual Deer Fest was just around the corner. Everyone in Bright Falls was bustling. There were banners to be hung, pies baked, deer mass sold. Bright Falls had made the top 100 American small town lists for its modest, rustic charm. The town expected a lot of tourists this year, but a shadow hung over the Deer Fest preparations. The forecast promised rain. Fearful whispers promised more murders. The police were on high alert. Sheriff Breaker had deputies patrolling the streets at night. Bright Falls was no stranger to odd happenings. But to cancel Deerfest? Out of the question. The townsfolk were anxious. Their anticipation mixed with fear. People had restless dreams. The lights seemed dimmer. Floodwater pressed in on the town. And the shadows poured in with it.
Another one of those rhymes. think, Saga. Okay. Hello, dear.
One remaining.
A charm for my bracelet. another one of those cult boxes. There's a rhyme over here. doesn't look right. Nah. Nope. Keep trying. Okay. another rhyme. Makes sense. Another cult stash?
Those people just burst in here and expect others to clean up after them. They think they're so mysterious with their ridiculous masks. Children in costumes.
Fishes are biting again.
Another cult box.
Good thing the flooding's done away with, too. Like the water's in a bad mood.
It won't open.
Oh, hello there.
Another locked box.
She wouldn't just wander off and not tell us. Especially after all the weirdness of the law.
Well, I'm fucking worried too. You just had to follow some...
Look, we just need to find Marcy.
Thank you.
It's not opening.
Good grub you got here.
And glasses.